your next sum, that is fourth sum. Hope you have all done the sums which I have given to you. Okay, your fourth sum is show that the equations 5x plus 3y plus 7 is equal to 4 and 3x plus 26y plus 2 is equal to 9, 7x plus 2y plus 10 is equal to 5 are consistent, and solve them by rank method. So we're going to solve this using rank method. Okay, so previous what we have seen, unique solution. So unique solution, your rank will get 3, but here what they have given is consistent. So consistent, your rank may be either 3 or 2 or even 1. Okay, so that one we're going to find out. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to take the given equation in the matrix form. Okay, so matrix form means C5, x coefficient and y coefficient and your z coefficients. Okay, next your variables, that is x, y, z, which is equal to, and the values, rest of the values 4, 9 and 5. So after that, what you need to do is your matrix, right, that part is your A, and your variable parts are x, which is equal to this value is B. So I'm going to write my augmented matrix. So augmented matrix is nothing but I'm going to combine my A value and B value. So what is A value? Is your bigger matrix and B is your smaller matrix, right? So we have to, for finding rank, we're supposed to use this symbol. Okay, so 5 3 7 4, I'm just combining the value. So 3 26 2 9 7 2 10 5. So after combining, so what is my work is to make this triangle is 0. Okay, this part I need to make it as 0. So what is this form is called? As I said in the previous sum, it's what this part is called? It is called as echelon form. If I made this value as 0, miss, that is called as echelon. From the question, maybe asked like this also. Solve this sum using echelon form. Okay, so for that you don't want to panic and all, because echelon form is same as your rank method only. Okay, so for finding, now see, for finding this value is 0, first of all we need to see all the rows and columns, whether I have one or I don't have one. Okay, so see, in this matrix I don't have one. Okay, so it is must I have to proceed with these values only. So what I said, I need to make this value as 0 first. So what is the procedure of making this value as 0? I can subtract 3 with 3, so which is equal to 0. But I don't have 1 here, so I couldn't multiply. So what we should do is, I have to multiply my 5 with 3 and 3 with 5. So now see, if I multiply means you have to multiply throughout the rows. Okay, not only the first element, you have to multiply throughout the rows. So if I multiply 3 with 5, I'll be getting 15, and 5 with 3, 15. So now my both the elements are 15. So after I subtract means what is the answer? 0. So I got easily. Okay, well, so that I'm going to multiply the value. So how will you write this as R2? So I'm going to change this value only. So R2 means what? This is R1, that is your row 1. R2 row 2, R3 row 3. So R2 gives 5R2 minus 3R1. 5R2 means I'm going to multiply my 5 with R2 and 3 with R1. So see, first of all, 5R2 minus 3R1. So I've written here, see, 5R2, na, this is my 5 R2. So I multiply 5 into 3, 15. 5 into 26 gives you 130. 5 into 2, 10, 5, 9, so 45. So first is over. Next is what I need to do. I need to multiply 3 with what? R1. So now multiply 3 into 5, 15. 3 into 3, 9. 3, 7, 21. 3, 4, 12. So after you finding, I need to get this value as 0, right? Now these are your new rows, but you should not write this is here. Okay, it will be like a rough part only. So after finding the answer only, you need to write that row. Okay, now subtract the value. 15 minus 15 is 0, and 130 minus 9 is 121. 10 minus 21 is minus 11. See, you're supposed to see the symbol also. Okay, so 21 is a greater number, So after subtracting, I'll be getting the answer as minus 11. And 45 minus 12 is 33. So this is your new R2 value. So see, I've written my new R2. 0, 121, minus 11 and 33. Now, I'm going to find out my R3 value. For finding R3 value, so what I'm going to do is, wait, I'll drop this first. Okay. So now I made this value 0. Now I have to make this value 0. Okay. So now your new R2 is 0, 121, minus 11, 33. So I'm going to multiply. Here it is 7, right? So I'm multiplying my 7 with 5 and 5 with 7. Okay. Now multiply. You have done, see, 5R3 minus 7R1. So 5R3 na your row 3 value I'm multiplying with 5. So 5 into 7, 35. 5 into 2, 10. 5, 10, 50. 5 into 5, 25. And 7R1. 7 into 5, 35. 7 into 3, 21. 7 into 7, 49. 7, 4, 7, 28. I need to take this value as 0, so I'm multiplying these values. I could not multiply with this because my new R2 was started with 0. So if I multiply now, I don't get any values and all, okay? So I'm going to multiply with R1, okay, children? So after I subtracting, my values will be 0, minus 11, 1, minus 3. You're supposed to see minus as well, okay? Because the greater number symbol only supposed to use the value. Okay, so 0, minus 11, 1, minus 3. So now I've got these two values as 0. Now one more thing, which thing I need to make it a 0? This value, right? So for finding this value, I'm going to take the R2 value. Now see the elements in the R2. I'm having 121, minus 11, 33. Okay, in which table this all the things will get cancelled? In which table? Yes, 11 tables. I can cancel everything in 11 table because 121 divided by 11 gives you 11. Okay, 11 times it will go. Minus 11 divided by 11 gives you minus 1. And 33 divided by 11 gives you 3. 3 times it will go. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to divide my R2 by 11. See, what are the things you're going to do? You're supposed to write like this. Okay, there is a separate mark for this. Okay. So if it is a 5 mark sum, you will be having a 2 marks for these things. What are the things you are writing and all. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to divide my R2 by 11. So which gives me 0, 11, minus 1, 3 and this part. Now see, 11 minus 11. So now what symbol I used to do in order to make this value a 0? Plus and minus. I need to take plus. I need to add the value. I could not minus. Okay. If I minus now, see here. 11 minus minus 11 because I already have minus 11. Okay. So 11, it will get plus 11. So which gives me 22. So which gives wrong. So I'm going to add the value. Add na 11 plus. We're going to R3 plus R1. So minus 11 plus 11 which is equal to 0. So I'm adding the value. So minus 11 plus 11 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. 3 minus 3 is 0. So everything I got it as 0. Okay, wow. So R3 plus R2. Okay, now your values are 0, 0, 0, 0. Now I made it as a value. See, echelon form. Did I make it or not? Yeah, I made it. Okay, see, this triangle part, I have made it as 0. Now you need to find out the rank. You have both the values, two values, right? So one is this part, which is nothing but this matrix is called as row of A, okay? And the whole matrix is called as row of A comma B. So I supposed to make the rank value. So how will you find rank? How I said, you to find out the rank value, non-zero rows, okay? Non-zero rows, the rows which have the elements, not all the elements are zero, okay? So see, this row is, I have the elements. And this row, I too have the elements, see, 11 and minus 1. But this row, I don't have any elements. I have only 0. So my rank will be what? 2. So row of A equal to 2. And row of A comma B na same non-zero rows tha. So see your first row, everything will be having the element. So second row also you are having the non-zero element. But third row see, you don't have any element other than 0. Okay, so what is your row of A, B? Row of AB equal to 2. Okay, write this as R2. So I'm going to change this value only. So R2 means what? This is R1. That is your row 1. R2 row 2. R3 row 3. So R2 gives 5R2 minus 3R1. 5R2 means I'm going to multiply my 5 with R2 and 3 with R1. So see, first of all 5R2 minus 3R1. So I've written here, see, 5R2 na, this is my 5 R2. So I'm multiplying 5 into 3, 15. 5 into 26 gives you 130. 5 into 2, 10. 5 9, so 45. So first is over. Next is what I need to do. I need to multiply 3 with what? R1. So now multiply 3 into 5, 15. 3 into 3, 9. 3, 7, 21. 3, 4, 12. So after you finding, I need to get this value as 0, right? Now these are your new rows, but you should not write this is here. Okay, it will be like a rough part only. So after finding the answer only, you need to write that row. Okay, now subtract the value. 15 minus 15 is 0. And 130 minus 9 is 121. 10 minus 21 is minus 11. See, you're supposed to see the symbol also. Okay, so 21 is a greater number. So after subtracting, I'll be getting the answer as minus 11. And 45 minus 12 is 33. So this is your new R2 value. So see, I've written my new R2. 0, 121, minus 11 and 33. Now, I'm going to find out my R3 value. For finding R3 value, so what I'm going to do is, wait, I'll drop this first. Okay. So now I made this value 0. Now I have to make this value 0. Okay. So now your new R2 is 0, 121, minus 11, 33. So I'm going to multiply. Here it is 7, right? So I'm multiplying my 7 with 5 and 5 with 7. Okay. Now multiply. You have done, see, 5R3 minus 7R1. So 5R3 na your row 3 value I'm multiplying with 5. So 5 into 7, 35. 5 into 2, 10. 5, 10, 50. 5 into 5, 25. And 7R1. 7 into 5, 35. 7 into 3, 21. 7 into 7, 49. 7, 4, 7, 28. I need to take this value as 0. So I'm multiplying these values. I could not multiply with this because my new R2 was started with 0. So if I multiply now, I don't get any values and all. Okay. So I'm going to multiply with R1. Okay, children. So after I subtracting, my values will be 0, minus 11, 1, minus 3. You're supposed to see minus as well. Okay. Because the greater number symbol only supposed to use the value. Okay. So 0, minus 11, 1, minus 3. So now I've got these two values as 0. Now one more thing, which thing I need to make it a 0? This value, right? So for finding this value, I'm going to take the R2 value. Now see the elements in the R2. I'm having 121, minus 11, 33. Okay. What in which table this all the things will get cancelled? In which table? Yes, 11 tables. I can cancel everything in 11 table because because 121 divided by 11 gives you 11. Okay, 11 times it will go. Minus 11 divided by 11 gives you minus 1. And 33 divided by 11 gives you 3. 3 times it will go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide my R2 by 11. See, what are the things you're going to do? You're supposed to write like this. Okay, there is a separate mark for this. Okay, so if it is a 5 mark sum, you'll be having a 2 marks for these things. What are the things you are writing and all? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to divide my R2 by 11. So which gives me 0, 11, minus 1, 3 and this part. Now see, 11 minus 11. So now what symbol I used to do in order to make this value 0? Plus or minus. I need to add the value. I could not minus. Okay, if I minus now, see you. 11 minus minus 11 because already have minus 11. Okay, so 11, it will get plus 11, so which gives me 22, so which gives wrong. So I'm going to add the value. Add na 11 plus first is we're going to add 3, sorry, so minus 11 plus 11 which is equal to 0. So I'm adding the value. So minus 11 plus 11 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0, 3 minus 3 is 0. So everything I got it as 0. Okay, wow. So R3 plus R2. Okay, now your values are 0, 0, 0, 0. Now I need to, I made it as a value. See, echelon form. Did I make it or not? Yeah, I made it. Okay, see, my this triangle part, I have made it as 0. Now you need to find out the rank. You have both the values, two values, right? So one is this part, which is nothing but this matrix is called as row of A, okay? And the whole matrix is called as row of A comma B. So I supposed to make the rank value. So how will you find rank? How I said, you to find out the rank value, non-zero rows, okay? Non-zero rows, na the rows which have the elements, not all the elements are zero, okay? So see, this row is, I have the elements, and this row I to have the elements, see, 11 and minus 1, but this row I don't have any elements, I have only 0. So my rank will be what? 2. So row of A equal to 2, and row of A comma B na same non-zero rows now. So see, your first row everything will be having the element. So second row also you are having the non-zero element, but third row, see, you don't have any element other than 0. Okay, so what is your row of A? B, row of AB equal to 2. Okay, row of A equal to 2 and row of A comma B equal to 2. Both row of A and row of A comma B are equal. After you find out the rank value, you have to see the matrix in your A matrix. You have to see the A matrix. So A matrix is your question. From the question only I have written my A matrix, right? So you have to see the A matrix. What type of matrix is this? It is 3 cross 3 matrix, right? So most probably your sums, your matrix will be 3 cross 3 only, okay? You will not be having 2 cross 2 matrix enough. So 3 cross 3 matrix now, that will be called as number of unknowns. So what is your number of unknowns equal to? 3. Okay, so what I'm going to conclude is my row of A equal to row of E, that is equal to 2, right? Row of A and row of A comma B equal to 2, but that 2 is less than my number of unknown, correct? Because 2 is obviously less than your 3 value, right? So row of A equal to row of A comma B equal to 2, that is less than 3. So what I'm going to conclude is it is equal, so consistent, but with infinite solution they are telling, because that value is less than 3. So if it is less than 3 na, I will be getting that as infinite solution. Okay, if everything is equal now, if row of A equal to 3, row of A comma B equal to 3, so an unknown is equal to 3 na, your answer will be unique solution, but have got less than 3, so my answer is infinite solution. After finding the solution, what we should do? We need to make this as a equation form. Now, how we will find equation? This is 5x plus 3y plus 7 is that equal to 4. That is your first equation. Next, you don't have x value because 0. So, y value is 11y minus 1 is minus z equal to 3. And that is your second equation. Okay. And I'm going to find out my values. What are the values I need to find out? X, Y and Z. But see, in third row, I don't have any Z value. Since I don't have any Z value, I'm going to consider my Z value as some K. So, I'm just assuming the value. That's it. You can also take any other constant. Z equal to S, T, U, V, whatever the elements you want, you can take it. But what I'm taking is, I'm taking Z equal to K. So, substituting my value in 2. If I substituting the value into na, I'll be getting y value. Okay, now see 11y minus, instead of z, k equal to 3. So what are the value I need to get here? Y value. So I'm keeping my 11y here and taking my minus k to this side, so it will gives you plus k, and I'm keeping my y value as it is, and taking my 11 to this side means multiplication 11 will goes this side, means it will be becomes plus 11. So I found out the value of y, and already have the value of z. So z and y, so I'm going to substitute z and y in the first equation. So 5x plus 3, y value is what? 3 plus k divided by 11 plus 7 is it. Z value is k. So 7k equal to 4. So after that I'm going to multiply the value. So 3 into 3 is 9. 3 into k is 3k. And multiplying my 11 to, in order to make all the denominators same, I'm going to multiply the value. So 11 into 5, 55x. Plus 9 plus 9k plus 11 into 7, 77. I cannot multiply 11 with these terms because already have the denominator as 11. So I can only multiply my 11 with other rest of the terms. Okay. So 11 into 5, 55x. 11 into 7, 77k equal to 4. After that, I'm going to multiply my 11 to 4, which gives me 44. And one more thing. See, these variables are equal. So I'm going to add these two values. So if the only case you have to have, you need to have the variables as equal only, you can add the element. You cannot add the variables with the different variables, okay? So 3k plus 77k equal to 80k. Now I need only to have x value. So I'm keeping my x value and taking all other terms to this side. So if 9 goes that side means minus 9 and minus 80k and 44 minus 9. 35 minus 80k. So I'm keeping my x, taking my 55 to this side, this will be divided by 55. So I'm taking, what is the common term here in the numerator, which is the common term I can take outside, it is 5. So I can take 5 outside. So if I take 5 outside means my answer will be 7 minus 16k divided by 55. So if I cancel now 11 times, your final answer will be 7 minus 16k divided by 11. So I found out the value of x and y value and your z value. That's all your first. That I'm going to multiply the value. So 3 into 3 is 9. 3 into k is 3k. And multiplying my 11 to, in order to make all the denominators same, I'm going to multiply the value. So 11 into 5, 55x plus 9 plus 9k. Plus 11 into 7, 77. I cannot multiply 11 with these terms because already have the denominator as 11. So I can only multiply my 11 with other rest of the terms. Okay. So 11 into 5, 55x. 11 into 7, 77k equal to 4. After that, I'm going to multiply my 11 to 4, which gives me 44. And one more thing. See, these variables are equal. So I'm going to add these two values. So if the only case you have to have, you need to have the variables as equal only, you can add the element. You cannot add the variables with the different variables, okay? So 3k plus 77k equal to 80k. Now I need only to have x value. So I'm keeping my x value and taking all other terms to this side. So if 9 goes that side means minus 9 and minus 80k and 44 minus 9. 35 minus 80k. So I'm keeping my x, taking my 55 to this side, this will be divided by 55. So I'm taking, what is the common term here in the numerator, which is the common term I can take outside, it is 5. So I can take 5 outside. So if I take 5 outside means my answer will be 7 minus 16k divided by 55. So if I cancel now 11 times, your final answer will be 7 minus 16k divided by 11. So I found out the value of x and y value and your z value. That's all your first. Fifth sum by your own. Your sixth sum is, for what values of the parameter lambda will the following equation fail to have a unique solution? And the equations are 3x minus y plus lambda z equal to 1, 2x plus y plus z equal to 2, x plus 2y minus lambda is equal to minus 1 by rank method. In the questions that they have given, fail to have unique solution. So your rank will not be 3, okay? So after finding the value, so the given equations I'm going to written in matrix form first. That is your first step. So see now, 3, your x coefficient, y minus 1, your y coefficient. And is it means you're supposed to write your coefficient as lambda. So lambda. And again 2, 1, 1. Here it will be 1, 2 minus lambda. And your variables will be x, y and z equal to the values 1, 2 and minus 1. So what is this matrix is called as your capital A. And your variables are capital X which is equal to B. So the same procedure only. So augmented matrix is what? A comma B. That will be denoted as we need to combine A and B. I have to combine it and write my A and B value. So 3 minus 1 lambda and 1. 2, 1, 1, 2. 1, 2 minus lambda and minus 1. Now see what I said. You need to first check whether you have any elements in the row is 1 or not. Okay, so now see, I have in this row, I have the value as 1. First of all, you need to find out in the row value. After that only, you need to move on to your column value. In row value, I have 1 here. So I'm going to interchange my rows. So what is this row is called as R1. I have written what is my R1, R2, R3. And after that, I'm going to interchange the rows because I have 1 here. See, first preferences, you need to see the row values. If you don't have 1 in row only, you have to go through the column values, okay? See, this column have 1 here. You should have the plus 1, not minus 1 and all, okay? But before that, I have here plus 1 in the row value. So, I'm going to interchange my R1 and R3. R1 means what? Row 1, row 2 and row 3, okay? Now, see, R3, I'm going to interchange as R1. This I'm going to interchanging and writing the values, okay? So 1, 2, minus lambda, minus 1. And R2 will be as it is 2, 1, 1, 2. And your R1 and your R3 will be your R1 value. 3, minus 1, lambda 1. And before that, what are the things you are going to do for the matrix? You're supposed to write it here. Even if it is multiplication also, even if it is division also, you're adding, you're subtracting, whatever it might be. Even if you're interchanging the values also, whatever you're doing with the row, you're supposed to write it here. Okay, even you can write it here or you can write it to the side of the matrix. Okay, so now what is the value? What is the thing I need to find out? Again, the same procedure only. See, this part I need to make it as what? 0. So 0, 0, 0. Why I'm doing this sum is because it is quite different because you have lambda. Okay, that's why I'm doing this sum. So 0, 0, 0 only. So what is this form is called as? What is this form is called as? Echelon form. Echelon form. Okay. So now what you should do? Now tell me, what is the first step you need to do for making it a 0? Is correct. For row 2, you have to multiply your 1 with what? 2. So which means, after that what I need to do? I need to subtract the value. Now see here, R2 gives me R2 minus 2R1. Okay. Shall I do it here? See, R2 value. First I am going to write my R2 value here. So R2 value is what? 2, 1, 1, 2. And minus 2R1. So 2R1 means you have to multiply 2 with R1 value. So 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into minus lambda is what? Minus 2 lambda. 2 into minus lambda is minus 2 lambda. It's not 2 minus lambda. Okay, that is wrong. 2 into, because I'm multiplying the value. So 2 into minus lambda is minus lambda. And 2 is minus 2 is minus 2. So what the next step? I'm going to subtract the value. Okay. So 2 minus 2 is 0. Next, 1 minus 4. 1 minus 4 is what? Is minus 3. Okay. Because the symbol also is supposed to see the value. Okay. Symbol. So next, 1 minus 2 lambda. So 1 you need to subtract the value minus of minus 2 lambda. So which gives you what? 1 minus into minus plus 2 lambda. So this value becomes 1 plus 2 lambda. And 2 minus of minus 2 is 4. So now this is going to be your new R2 value. Okay, have I made it as 0? Yes, I made it as 0. So my new R2 value is 0. Can you check that? 0, minus 3, 1 plus 2 lambda and 4. Okay, next is what? What is the next step? I need to find out this value is 0 and also this value is 0. For that, what you need to take? You have to multiply this value with 3. Okay, children, we have to multiply 3. After multiplying, I am going to subtract the value. So, I have written here, see, R3 gives me R3 minus 3R1. Okay, so I am going to multiply the value here. So, listen, this I am going to multiply. So, what is your R3 value? See, I am doing it here. R3 value is 3 minus 1 lambda 1. This is your R3 value. So, now I am going to do 3R1. 3R1 is what? 3 into 1? 3, 3 into 2 is 6, 3 into minus lambda is what? Yes, minus 3 lambda. 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. So after that you need to subtract the value. Now subtract it and tell me what is the answer you're getting. 3 minus 3 is 0, right? So 3 minus 3 is 0, minus 1. So minus 1 minus 6 is what? Because you need to subtract the values, right? So subtraction means for all the things you're going to, you need to subtract the value. So minus, 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 minus. So 1 minus 7 is what? I'm sorry, minus 1 minus 6 is equal to minus 7. So your answer is minus 7. And here, lambda, already one minus is here. And one more minus you need to do. So lambda minus of minus 3 lambda gives you lambda plus 3 lambda, that is 4 lambda. I'm adding the value. Okay, lambda plus 3 lambda equal to 4 lambda. So 1 plus 3 is 4. Okay children, so this is, I'm doing one more times here. Lambda, already one minus you need to do, that minus is here, minus 3 lambda. So which is equal to lambda plus 3 lambda gives you 4 lambda, that is here. And here it is 1 minus of minus 3 gives you 1 plus 3, which is equal to 4. So check 0 minus 7, 4 lambda and 4. So I need to take it as this value is 0, right? So finding this value, what I am going to do is I am going to change my row 1. Why I'm going to change my R1 means here I have already lambda. So I don't want that lambda. So that I'm going to change the value. Minus of minus 2 is 4. So now this is going to be your new R2 value. Okay, have I made it as 0? Yes, I made it as 0. So my new R2 value is 0. Can you check that? 0 minus 3, 1 plus 2 lambda and 4. Okay, next is what? What is the next step? I need to find out this value is 0 and also this value is 0. For that, what you need to take? You have to multiply this value with 3. Okay, children, we have to multiply 3. After multiplying, I am going to subtract the value. So, I have written here, see, R3 gives me R3 minus 3R1. Okay, so I am going to multiply the value here. See, listen. So I am going to multiply. So what is your R3 value? See it, I am doing it here. R3 value is 3 minus 1 lambda 1. This is your R3 value. So now I am going to do 3R1. 3R1 is what? 3 into 1? 3. 3 into 2 is 6. 3 into minus lambda is what? Yes, minus 3 lambda. 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. So after that you need to subtract the value. Now subtract it and tell me what is the answer you're getting. 3 minus 3 is 0, right? So 3 minus 3 is 0, minus 1. So minus 1 minus 6 is what? because you need to subtract the values, right? So subtraction means for all the things you're going to, you need to subtract the values. So minus, 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 minus. So 1 minus 7 is what? I'm sorry, minus 1 minus 6 is equal to minus 7. So your answer is minus 7. And here lambda, already one minus is here, and one more minus you need to do. So lambda minus of minus 3 lambda gives you lambda plus 3 lambda, that is 4 lambda. I'm adding the value. Okay, lambda plus 3 lambda equal to 4 lambda. So 1 plus 3 is 4. Okay children, so this is, I'm doing one more times here. Lambda, already one minus you need to do, that minus is here, minus 3 lambda. So which is equal to lambda plus 3 lambda gives you 4 lambda, that is here. And here it is 1 minus of minus 3 gives you 1 plus 3, which is equal to 4. So check 0, minus 7, 4 lambda and 4. So I need to take it as this value is 0, right? So finding this value, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to change my row 1. Why I'm going to change my R1 means, here I have already lambda. So I don't want that lambda. So that I'm going to change the value. This part is 0. So only one thing, I need to make this as 0. Okay. So since now, see here it is lambda. I don't want here it is lambda. So I'm going to change this value. Okay. Well, after that I'm moving to this value was 0. Okay. So what I'm going to do is, what value this is, what row this is, R1. So R1, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add my R1 with my R3, that is divided by 4. Okay. If I divide my R3 by 4 now, what value I'll be getting here? 4 divided by 4 gets cancelled, balance lambda, so lambda minus lambda is 0. So we'll be getting lambda. So I'm doing here. Okay, so what I'm given here? R1 gives you R1 plus R3 divided by 4. Okay, so R3 divided by 4 now. Since I don't want the first element as first row itself, I don't want lambda. For that, I'm going to changing the values. Okay, so now see. First time writing here my R1 value. What is your R1 value? 1, 2, minus lambda, minus 1. Okay. So, 1, 2, minus lambda, minus 1. And next thing is what? R3 divided by 4, right? So, R3 divided by 4. So R3 divided by 4 na, 0 minus 4 is what? 0. So I'm writing here, 0 minus 4 is 0, and next is 7 by 4, right? Next is 4 lambda divided by 4, and next is 4 by 4. Okay, since the only thing I need not to get here it is 0, so I'm just changing that value, that's it. Okay. So after that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add the value. So 1 plus 0 is what? 1. And 2, if it plus also what? Here it is minus. So minus into plus gives you minus. Okay. So here I'm doing 2 minus 7 by 4. So how will you change this? You have to cross multiply. So 4 2's are 8 minus 7 divided by 4 gives you 1 by 4. So 1 by 4. And now see, shall I cancel this 4, 4? If I cancel now, here it is 1, here it is only lambda. So minus lambda plus lambda gives you what? 0. And minus 1 plus 1 is 0. So now this is your new R1 value. See, 1, 1 by 4, 0, 0. The only thing is, I don't want to get lambda value. For that only I'm changing. Now we can move towards to minus 7, because we need to make that value a 0. That is the completion of sum. Okay. So R3, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to multiply my R3 with 3 and 7 with R3. The previous sum is we have done, right? So if I don't have any value, similar value now, I have to multiply 7 here I have to multiply 3 here. So I'm going to do now, see, 3 are 3 first. So 3 into 0, 0. 3 into minus 27, minus 21. 3 into 4, 12 lambda and 12. This is your 3R3 value. And 7R2 value, 7 into minus, 7 into 0, 0. See children, one more thing. If you want this term is 0 now, you have to see the R2, not R1. If you want these two terms are 0 now, you have to see the R1. Okay. If this value was, if this value need to take 0 now, you have to see this value only. So 0 and 7 into 1 plus 2 lambda. So 7 into 1 plus 2 lambda. Correct? So which gives me 7 into 1, 7 plus 14 lambda. So I'm writing here it is 7 plus 14 lambda. Okay, well, next is what? 12 lambda. So, into 4, 12 lambda and 12. This is your 3R3 value. And 7R2 value, 7 into minus, 7 into 0, 0. See children, one more thing. If you want this term is 0 now, you have to see the R2, not R1. If you want these two terms are 0 now, you have to see the R1. Okay, if this value was, if this value need to take 0 now, you have to see this value only. So 0 and 7 into 1 plus 2 lambda. So 7 into 1 plus 2 lambda. Correct? So which gives me 7 into 1, 7 plus 14 lambda. So I'm writing here it is 7 plus 14 lambda. Okay, well, next is what? 12 lambda. So I'm going to multiply my 7 with 3. So minus 21 and 7 into 1 plus 2 lambda is 7 plus 14 lambda, and 7 into 4 gives you 28. So after that, what we need to do? We have to subtract the values. So 0 minus 0, obviously 0. And see minus 21. Here it is one minus, and here it is another minus. So gives you minus 21 plus 21 equal to 0. So next is what? 12 lambda minus 14 lambda. And it here, wait. Now see, 12 lambda minus, this is two terms you have, right? Two terms here you have. So if you have two terms now, you have to write this is in the bracket value. So 14 lambda. So 12 lambda, now you have to multiply the symbol inside. So minus 7 minus 7 minus 14 lambda. Now check, you have 12 lambda minus 14 lambda. So 12 minus 14 is what? Minus 2. So already you have minus 7. So minus 7 minus 2 lambda. So your answer will be minus 7 minus 2 lambda. And 12 minus 28 is minus 16. So now this is your new row 3 value. So see, now your new row 3 value is 0, 0, minus 7, minus 2 lambda and minus 16. Okay. Now see, I need to have what I said before itself. The first row I don't have lambda because I need to make it as 0. I've done here the value. Similarly, in the second row also, I should not have lambda value. I should have the lambda value only in row 3. Okay. If I have the lambda values now, I need to change the value. So what for that I'm going to do my R2 as R3 plus R2. Just I'm adding the value. If I add means, what is the value I'm getting here? See, 0, minus 3, minus 6 and minus 12. Okay, I'll do here. So R3 value already 0, 0, minus 7, minus 2 lambda, minus 16. And R2, 0, minus 3, 1 plus 2 lambda and 4. Simply I am adding the value. So 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 minus 3 is minus 3. Now see, your this lambda and this lambda will get cancelled. Correct? Minus 2 lambda plus 2 lambda will get cancelled. So minus 7 plus 6 is what? Minus 7 plus 1 is what? Minus 6. So 16 plus 4 is minus 12. Now this is what your row? Your new row R2. So I don't have lambda, you see. So now I have the lambda only in third row. Okay, I should not have the lambda in any of the rows. I should have the lambda in only third row. So now I found the value of what value this is called as. Now I found echelon form. I found out the value 0, 0, 0. After that, we need to do what? We need to find out the rank value. So now see, first, since here it is 7 minus 7 minus 2 lambda. So first, I'm going to take my row of A comma B, not row of A, because I have the lambda here. So I'm not going to take this part. I'm going to take the whole part. So row of A comma B, na, what is your rank? 3. Non-zero rows, non-zero rows, non-zero. So your rank is 3. But see, what is the question they have given? That is fail to have unique solution. So your answer will not be a unique solution. Correct? So for that, I'm taking this value, that is this lambda value was 0. If I take the whole value was, that is minus 7 minus 2 lambda was 0, means what is your row of A will be? What is this value will be? Your value will be 0. Then your rank will be what? Row of A equal to 2. Wait, I'll write it here so that it will be clear to you. Okay. So since the whole term is lambda, right? So what I'm going to take is minus 7 minus 2 lambda equal to 0. If suppose I'm taking that as 0, na, what is your lambda value becomes? Minus 7. Minus 7 goes this side, means plus 7. And lambda equal to minus 7 by 2. Because this minus will go that side. So your lambda value becomes minus 7 by 2. So substitute this in your equation here. So minus 7 minus 2. What is your lambda value now? Minus 7 by 2. So 2 gets cancelled. So minus 7 minus into minus what? Plus 7, which is equal to 0. Okay, so minus 7 plus 7, I got the value was 0. So if in case I'm substituting my lambda value was minus 7 by 2 na, your answer will be equal to 0. Illiya, equal to 0. So appo what you have to do is you have to check all the values. Ippo enakku 0. Okay va? So 0. So now this will be the terms as it is. So because I've taken the row of A comma B equal to 3, if it is 0, what is my rank will be? I will be having only 2, because the whole terms are 0. Okay, but row of A equal to 2, row of A comma B equal to 3. But both the things are what? It is not equal. Okay, ma? If it is not equal, na, your answer will be inconsistent. Equal are in the matunna, that is consistent. If it is not equal, na, it is inconsistent, and of course that is no unique solution. There is no solution and all, because consistent and the you will be having unique solution. So it is inconsistent, so you will not be having a no unique solution, because the question itself they have given, it has failed to have a unique solution. So your answer is no unique solution. Okay children, I hope you have understood. Now see, I'll tell you this part again. So finally I've got the value row of A comma B equal to 3. I have the lambda value, right? So what I'm going to take is, I'm going to consider this value equal to 0. From that I'm going to take the lambda value. See, lambda value is what? Minus 7 by 2. So after finding the lambda value, I'm going to substitute this lambda value in the equation instead of lambda. So minus 7 minus 2, lambda value is what now? Minus 7 by 2. So 2 gets cancelled. Minus 7 minus into minus plus 7 equal to 0. See, now I've got the value. Appana, this value becomes what? 0. அப்போ நான் எடுத்திருக்க கண்டிஷன் இஸ் கரெக்ட். இஃப் இட் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோனா மை ரோ ஆஃப் ஏ வில் பி டூ, பிகாஸ் நான் ஜீரோ எலிமெண்ட்ஸ் ரெண்டு தான் வில் பி கெட்டிங். யூ வில் நாட் கெட் த தேர்ட் ரோ பிகாஸ் இட் வில் கோஸ் ஆன் ஜீரோ. சரியா? ஸோ ரோ ஆஃப் ஏக்குவல் டு ரோ ஆஃப் ஏக்கம்மா பி ஈக்குவல் டு த்ரீ. யூஸ்வலி இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் சம்ஸ்டர் நாள் வி ஹவ் சீன் ஒன்லி த ஈக்குவல் வேல்யூ இல்லையா, எதர் த்ரீ இட் இஸ் டூ, பட் வி நெவர் சீன் டூ அண்ட் த்ரீ. So it is totally not equal. If it is not equal na, your answer is inconsistent. If it is equal na, your answer is what? Consistent. That is, there is no unique solution. See, this is just a point to remember. If your row of A equal to row of A comma B equal to number of unknowns na, okay, row of A equal to row of B equal to number of unknowns na, your answer is consistent and unique solution. Chariya, second thing is your row of A, so for this example what we can say, equal to 3, we can say equal to 3. If your row of A equal to 3 and row of A comma B equal to 3 and your number of unknowns also equal to 3 na, your answer is consistent and unique solution. If row of A comma B equal to 2 but number of unknowns equal to 3 arundichina, what is the way, how will you write this as row of A equal to row of A comma B equal to 2, that is less than 3. These two equal, but that is what? Less than 3. So if it is so na, your answer is consistent with what? With infinite solution. And your third case is what? If your row of A is not equal to row of A comma B na, it is inconsistent and that is nothing but no solution. So only these three things, if you remember these three things na, you can able to do all the sums in this exercise, which is the important 5 marks concerned in the 5 mark question. So if you remember all just these three points after finding the rank, if you remember these three points now, so now see, first since here it is 7 minus 7 minus 2 lambda, so first I'm going to take my row of A comma B, not row of A, because I have the lambda here, so I'm not going to take this part, I'm going to take the whole part. So row of A comma B na, what is your rank? 3. Non-zero rows. So your rank is 3. But see, what is the question they have given? That is fail to have unique solution. So your answer will not be a unique solution. Correct? So for that, I am taking this value. That is, this lambda value was 0. If I take the whole value was, that is, minus 7 minus 2 lambda was 0, means what is your row of A will be, what is this value will be, your value will be 0, then your rank will be what, row of A equal to 2. Wait, I'll write it here so that it will be clear to you. Okay, so since the whole term is lambda, right, so what I'm going to take is minus 7 minus 2 lambda equal to 0. If suppose I'm taking that as 0 na, what is your lambda value becomes? Minus 7. Minus 7 goes this side means plus 7. And lambda equal to minus 7 by 2. Because this minus will goes that side. So your lambda value becomes minus 7 by 2. So substitute this in your equation here. So minus 7 minus 2, what is your lambda value now? Minus 7 by 2. So 2 gets cancelled. So minus 7 minus into minus what? plus 7 which is equal to 0. Okay, so minus 1 plus 7, I got the value was 0. So if in case I'm substituting my lambda value was minus 7 by 2 na, your answer will be equal to 0. Illiya, equal to 0. So appo what you have to do is you have to check all the values. Ippo enakku 0. Okay va? So 0. So now this will be the terms as it is. So because I've taken the row of a comma b equal to 3. If it is 0, what is my rank will be? I will be having only 2 because the whole terms are 0. Okay, va? Row of a equal to 2, row of a comma b equal to 3. But both the things are what? It is not equal. Okay, va? If it is not equal, na, your answer will be inconsistent. Equal aranda mattunna, that is consistent. If it is not equal, na, it is inconsistent, and of course that is no unique solution. There is no solution and all, because consistent you will be having unique solution, so it is inconsistent, so you will not be having a no unique solution, because the question itself they have given it has failed to have a unique solution, so your answer is no unique solution. Okay children, I hope you have understood. Now see, I'll tell you this part again. So finally I've got the value row of a comma b equal to 3. I have the lambda value here, right? So what I'm going to take is I'm going to consider this value equal to 0. From that I'm going to take the lambda value. See, lambda value is what? Minus 7 by 2. So after finding the lambda value, I'm going to substitute this lambda value in the equation instead of lambda. So minus 7 minus 2, lambda value is what now? Minus 7 by 2. So 2 gets cancelled. Minus 7 minus into minus plus 7 equal to 0. See, now I've got the value. Appana, this value becomes what? 0. Appana, edathirukka condition is correct. If it is equal to 0, na, my row of A will be 2. Because non-zero elements, 2 da, you'll be getting. You will not get the third row. Because it will goes on 0. Chariya? So row of A equal to 2. Row of A comma B equal to 3. Usually in the previous sums and all, we have seen only the equal value. Either 3, it is 2. But we never seen 2 and 3. So it is totally not equal. If it is not equal, na, your answer is inconsistent. If it is equal, na, your answer is what? Consistent. That is, there is no unique solution. See, this is just a point to remember. If your row of A equal to row of a comma b equal to number of unknowns, na, okay, row of a equal to row of b equal to number of unknowns, na, your answer is consistent and unique solution. Chariya? Second thing is your row of A. So for this example, what we can say equal to 3. We can say equal to 3. If your row of A equal to 3 and row of A comma B equal to 3 and your number of unknowns also equal to 3, na, your answer is consistent and unique solution. If row of A comma B equal to 2 but number of unknowns equal to 3 arundichina, what is the way? How will you write this as? Row of A equal to row of A comma B equal to 2, that is less than 3. These two equal, but that is what? Less than 3. So if it is so, na, your answer is consistent with what? With infinite solution. And your third case is what? If your row of A is not equal to row of A comma B, na, it is inconsistent. And that is nothing but no solution. So only these three things, if you remember these three things, na, you can able to do all the sums in this exercise, which is the important 5 marks comes under in the 5 mark question. So if you remember all just these 3 points after finding the rank, if you remember these 3 points, na, do the 7th sum by your own. I'm going to do the 8th sum. Based on the 8th sum, you will be having your 7th sum, okay? Since it is the percentage format, I'm doing this one, okay? So, see the question now. Read the question now. An amount of rupees 5000 is to be deposited in 3 different bonds, okay? There is giving us 3 different bonds. Bearing 6%, 7 and 8% per year. Total annual income is rupees 358. If the income from the first 2 investments is rupees 70 more than the income from the third, then find the amount of investment in each bond by rank method. So first, that 3 bonds they are given, layer. So that 3 bonds I'm going to take it as XYZ. So now see, XYZ is deposited my how much rupees? 5000 rupees. So X plus Y plus Z equal to rupees 5000. That is your first question. And next is, they have given 6%, 7 and 8%. First instance, how will you be writing? 6 by 100x. Because already I have said 3 bonds is X, Y and Z. So 6% I am going to write it as 6 by 100x plus 7 by 100y plus 8 by 100z equal to 358 rupees. Correct? Yeah? So now all the denominators are equal here. So I am going to just multiplying the denominator to the value, so which gives me 35800. Just multiplying the value, okay, children. You can use the calculator, right? So you can, whenever you're going to do the sum, please have the calculator with you, so that you can, it is easy for you to multiply and do it the values. So that is your second value. And now see to the third value. What they have given us is the income from the first 2 investment. So there is income from the first 2 investment. So first 2 investment is what? 6 by 100x, 7 by 100y. And what they have given is 70% more than the income from the third. So the income from the first 2 values is 70% more than the third value. So third value is what? 8 divided by 100. Because this is the higher value. So what they are giving is, it is 70% more than the value. So obviously that will be lesser value, correct? Because I am saying this value is the more, this is the less value. So minus 8 by 100. Now this value also I am having 100, the same denominator. Cross multiplying the value, which gives me 7000. That is your third equation. Now see, I have found the 3 equation. After that, what you need to do is, you need to find the matrix form. You need to write it in the matrix form. So I've done here 1 1 1 6 7 8 6 7 minus 8, and X, Y, Z, and the values 5000 35800 and 7000. So after that, same procedure only, children, okay? So X plus equal to B, X equal to B, and of course augmented matrix. After that, what you need to find this value is 0. Now see here, third and second row, see, I have same values, correct? 6 is 6, 7 is 7, I have same. So what I can do, I can directly subtract the values. So only R3 I can subtract, I couldn't subtract R2, because R2 you need to multiply 6 here. R3 na, I can directly subtract the values. So I have subtracted and done it here. See, R3 gives me R3 minus R2. So after I subtracted, means my answer will get 0, 0, minus 16, minus 2, 800. So since you have the elements are bigger, you can use the calculator and you can do the sum, okay? So next is, I need to take this value as 0. So I have found it, these 2 values are 0. The only thing is, I need to change this value as 0. For that, I need to multiply my 6 with this value. I have not multiplied, I am showing, because already we have done so much sums, okay? So I am doing it directly. So you have to do and check it, whether I am getting, you also getting the same answer or not, okay, children? So 0 1 2 5 8 0 0. So after I found the value, see, found the value, you is supposed to take the rank. So this rank is what? This rank is what? Row of A, and the whole part is row of A comma B. See row of A and row of A comma B and row of 3. Okay, everything, I'm sorry, number of unknowns 3. So everything is 3. So after that, what you should do? You have to go to the matrix and you have to make it as the equation form. So x, this is also important. You need to make it as an equation. So after finding, see x, y, z, here x value is 0, y, z, here y, x and y is 0, z value. So I'm finding the equation, 3 equations. From the 6th equation, I'm going to take the z value. So z equal to minus minus is cancel. So if I divide, my answer is 1800. So after this, as usual, you have to substitute the z value in the 5th equation. So I'll be getting y value. So see children, you're supposed to use the calculator and just multiply it and subtract it and find out the answer. Okay, bam. Check whether you're also getting the same answer or not. So y equal to 2200 and z and y and substituting in the first equation. So after I substituted, I get the value of x value. So what they have asked the question, we need to find out the 3 bonding values, right? So bond 1 is nothing but your x, bond 2 is y, and bond 3 is z. So just return the value of x and y, z. Okay, these are the questions will come to the 5 marks, okay, in the first chapter. And next is Cramer's rule. I'm moving to your next topic, which is Cramer's rule, that is exercise 1.2. In this first sum, you will be having 5 subdivisions. But I'm going to do only 2 subdivisions because everything is same pattern only, which is quite easy. I'm doing one sum from 2x2 matrix and one sum from 3x3 matrix. Okay, do the all these other sums by your own. Such a easy sum only, so that only I'm leaving unto you. Okay, so first I'm taking my first equation. What is that? 2x plus 3y equal to 7, 3x plus 5y equal to 9. Okay, so for that, this step is not necessary. If you want, you can write, but that is not necessary. So delta is nothing but it's supposed to take the coefficient of x, y. Okay, va, see the question, it is Cramer's rule. Chariya? So 2, 3. 2, 3 and 3, 5. Delta value is only you need to take the x and y coefficients. Okay, va? So 2, 3 na cross multiply the value. Delta na just need to cross multiply the value, which is nothing but you're going to take the determinant value. Okay, va? Determinant value 2, 5 is 10, 3, 3 is 9. So 10 minus 9 is 1, that is not equal to 0. You should not get the answer as 0 here. Okay, va? So that is the important point. You should not get the answer as 0 here. So what is your delta value now? Delta equal to 1. Okay, va? Till the sum, we are going to do only the determinant value. So delta equal to 1. Next is what are the two variables I have, x and y. So what is the thing is, I'm going to find out delta x and delta y. So delta x is nothing but, see, instead of this value is right here, this is your x coefficient here, right? So instead of this value, I need to have these two values, 7 and 9. Chariya, instead of x, because I'm going to find out x, so I'm going to take these 2 and 3 outside. I'm going to put 7 and 9 inside. So 7, 9, 3, 5. All other values are same only. Instead of x, I have to substitute the equal to part. Okay, well, after that, you need to cross multiply the value. So 7, 5 is what? 35. 3 into 9 equal to 27. In order to combine, we need to use the symbol as minus. Okay. So delta x is equal to, subtract the value, 8. And delta y na, delta y means you have to see the value of your delta. Wait, I'll drop this and I'll let you know. Okay. Delta y na, your x will be as it is. Okay, wow. But instead of y, what you need to substitute this value, just a simple value, delta x na, instead of x you need to substitute this value. This value is nothing but equal to part value. and delta y na instead of 5 you need to substitute the value. So instead of 3 and 5 I'm going to substitute 7 and 9. After that cross multiplication, so 9 into 2 is 18 and 7 into 3 minus 21. Minuses, in order to combine these two values you have to put minus here. So after subtracting, what is your answer? Minus 3. So your aim is to find out xy, because since it is a 2 cross 2 matrix you need to find out x and y value. If it is 3 cross 3 matrix, now what are the values you need to find out? X, y and z. Yes, correct. Okay, x1, y and z you need to find out. Now x is nothing but delta x divided by delta, and y is delta y divided by delta. Delta x is what here? Eta. So 8 divided by what is your delta value? 1. So 1. 8 by 1 is what? 8. And delta y again minus 3. Delta is what? 1. So if I cancel now, what is your answer? Minus 3. Because R2 you need to multiply 6 here. R3 na I can directly subtract the values. So I've subtracted and done it here. See, R3 gives me R3 minus R2. So after I subtracted means my answer will get 0, 0, minus 16, minus 2800. So since you have the elements are bigger, you can use the calculator and you can do the sum. Okay. So next is I need to take this value as 0. So I found it, these two values are 0. The only thing is I need to change this value as 0. For that I need to multiply my 6 with this value. I have not multiplied, I am showing, because already we have done so much sums. Okay. So I am doing it directly. So you have to do and check it whether I'm getting, you also getting the same answer or not. Okay, children. So 0 1 2 5 8 double 0. So after I found the value, is supposed to take the rank. So this rank is what? Row of A, and the whole part is row of A comma B. See, row of A and row of A comma B and row of 3. Everything, I'm sorry, number of unknowns 3. So everything is 3. So after that, what you should do? You have to go to the matrix and you have to make it as an equation form. So x, this is also important. You need to make it as an equation. So after finding, say, x, y, z, here x value is 0, y is z, here y, x and y is 0, z value. So I'm finding the equation, 3 equations. From the 6th equation, I'm going to take the z value. So z equal to minus minus is cancel. So if I divide, my answer is 1800. So after this, as usual, you have to substitute the z value in the 5th equation. So you will be getting y value. So see children, you're supposed to use the calculator and just multiply it and subtract it and find out the answer. Okay, well, check whether you're also getting the same answer or not. So y equal to 2200 and z and y, I'm substituting in the first equation. So after I substituted, I get the value of x value. So what they have asked the question, we need to find out the three bonding values, right? So bond 1 is nothing but your x, bond 2 is y, and bond 3 is z. So just return the value of x and y, z. Okay. These are the questions will come to the 5 marks, okay, in the first chapter. And next is Cramer's rule. I'm moving to your next topics, which is Cramer's rule, that is exercise 1.2. In this first sum, you will be having 5 subdivisions, but I'm going to do only 2 subdivisions because everything is same pattern only, which is quite easy. I'm doing one sum from 2 cross 2 matrix and one sum from 3 cross 3 matrix. Okay, do the all this other sums by your own. Such a easy sum only, so that only I'm leaving unto you. Okay, so first I'm taking my first equation. What is that? 2x plus 3y equal to 7. 3x plus 5y equal to 9. Okay. So for that, this step is not necessary. If you want, you can write, but that is not necessary. So delta is nothing but it's supposed to take the coefficient of xy. Okay. See the question. It is Cramer's rule. Charya. So 2, 3. Charya. So 2, 3. 2, 3 and 3, 5. Delta value is only you need to take the x and y coefficients. Okay, so 2, 3 na cross multiply the value. delta ane just need to cross multiply the value, which is nothing but you're going to take the determinant value. Okay ba, determinant value 2 5 is 10, 3 3 is 9, so 10 minus 9 is 1, that is not equal to 0. You should not get the answer as 0 here. Okay ba, so that is the important point, you should not get the answer as 0 here. So what is your delta value now? Delta equal to 1. Okay ba, till the sum we are going to do only the determinant value. So delta equal to 1. Next is what are the two variables here, x and y. So what is the thing is, I am going to find out delta x and delta y. So delta x is nothing but, see, instead of this value is right here, this is your x coefficient here, right? So instead of this value, I need to have these two values, 7 and 9. Chariya, instead of x, because I'm going to find out x, so I'm going to take these 2 and 3 outside, I'm going to put 7 and 9 inside. So 7, 9, 3, 5, all other values are same only. Instead of x, I have to substitute the equal to part. Okay, well, after that you need to cross multiply the value. So 7, 5 is what? 35. 3 into 9 equal to 27. In order to combine, we need to use the symbol as minus, okay? So delta x is equal to, subtract the value, 8. And delta y now, delta y means you have to see the value of your delta. Wait, I'll drop this and I'll let you know. Okay. Delta y now, your x will be as it is, okay, but instead of y, what you need to substitute this value, just a simple value, delta x na, instead of x you need to substitute this value, this value is nothing but equal to part value, and delta y na, instead of y you need to substitute the value. So instead of 3 and 5 I'm going to substitute 7 and 9, 6, 7 and 9, after that cross multiplication. So 9 into 2 is 18 and 7 into 3 minus 21. Minuses, in order to combine these two values you have to put minus here. So after subtracting, what is your answer? Minus 3. So your aim is to find out xy, because since it is a 2 cross 2 matrix you need to find out x and y value. If it is 3 cross 3 matrix now, what are the values you need to find out? X, y and z. Yes, correct. Okay, x1, y and z you need to find out. Now x is nothing but delta x divided by delta, and y is delta y divided by delta. Delta x is what here? 8. So 8 divided by, what is your delta value? 1. So 1. 8 by 1 is what? 8. And delta y again? Minus 3. Delta is what? 1. So if I cancel now, what is your answer? Minus 3. X equal to 8 and y equal to minus 3. Okay, x and y I found. I am going to my fourth sum. 3 cross 3 matrix. So first delta value is nothing but you're supposed to take your coefficients alone. Okay, ba? Coefficient value. So what is your coefficient? 1, 1, 1 and 2, 3, minus 1. First equation you're supposed to write it in the row by only, not in a column part. You have to write it in the row. So 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 6, minus 2, minus 3. So first is delta. What I said, delta na, throughout the sum you're supposed to find out the determinant value. Okay, determinant part only. So in 3 cross 3 matrix, how will you find the determinant value? Yes, you're supposed to take the first element. So if I take first element, na, corresponding rows and columns will go away. And the balance term, so directly I've done, because we have done so many sums under the determinant value. So I'm doing directly. So 3 into minus 3 is minus 9. And minus 1 into minus 2 is plus 2, and the symbol you are supposed to do is minus 2. So minus 2. Next, this one and minus 1. Plus minus plus minus plus minus plus minus plus. So this is the symbol, right, for 3 cross 3 matrix. Next, if you take 1, what is your symbol? Minus. So if you minus 1, the corresponding column and row will go. So 2 into 3, minus 6. Minus 1 into 6 is plus 6. Because already one more minus is there, so it will give you plus 6. Next, plus 1. and corresponding row and column will go. Next you will be having this elements, right? So 2 into minus 2 is minus 4, 3 is 16. So after the bracket parts I'm going to get solved. This term is 0. So 0 into 1 is 0 only. So I'm not taking that. So I'm taking the rest of the terms. So this will be minus 11 minus 22 gives you minus 33. So delta value gets over. Next is what? Delta x. Since it is 3 cross 3 matrix, what are the things you need to find out? Is x, y and z value. X, y and z value you need to find out. So now you have to take the 6, 5 and minus 7. Okay. So here I am writing 6, 5, minus 7. So now it is delta x. So what you supposed to do? You have to wait. I erase it and come wait. Okay. So since it is delta x, what you need to do? Instead of x value, because this is the x coefficients, right? These are the y coefficient and these are the z coefficient. So instead of x coefficient, you have to substitute 6, 5 and minus 7. So after you writing the value, you need to what? Take the determinant. So determinant as usual. First element and corresponding rows and columns get over. So you'll be having the delta x value. Okay, same thing. Minus 9 minus 2 is minus 11. Minus 15 minus 7 is minus 22. And minus 10 plus 21 is 11. After multiplying, I'll be getting the final answer is minus 33. Next is what? Delta y. So delta y now, moving to delta value. So this is my y coefficient, right? So instead of y coefficient, you need to substitute 6, 5 and minus 7. So instead of y coefficient, you need to substitute this value, x and z as it is. Okay, but instead of 1, 3, minus 2, you have to substitute 6, 5, minus 7. See, 6, 5, minus 7. After finding, you have to find the determinant value, that is your delta y value. And delta z, na? So your z value. So z value, instead of z value, you have to take this value and these two values remains as it is. Okay, well, these two values remains as it is. So I've taken the determinant. So my final answer is minus 99. So how will you find out x, y and z? Yeah, this is the formula. Delta x divided by delta. And for y, delta y divided by delta. And for z, delta z divided by delta. So what is your delta x? Minus 33. And your delta value is minus 33. So minus 33 divided by 33. If I cancel balance, your answer is 1. And y value is minus 66 divided by minus 33, your answer is 2. And this is minus 99 divided by minus 33, your answer is 3. So your x equal to 1, y equal to 2, and z equal to 3. Okay, ba? So this is your fourth sum. Do the rest of the sum in first Roman letter. So I'll be doing the second Roman letter in the next session. So since it is easy sums only, right? Because you need to find out delta x, delta y and delta z. Okay. After that, you need to find out x, y and z. So do the sums in this part. And as well, here I've done 8th sum. You're supposed to do 7th sum. And 7th sum and 5th sum. Right? Yes. 5th, 7th and your rest of the sum in first Roman letter. Okay, children. Thank you. So you'll be having the delta x value. Okay, same thing. Minus 9 minus 2 is minus 11. Minus 15 minus 7 is minus 22. And minus 10 plus 21 is 11. After multiplying, I'll be getting the final answer is minus 33. Next is what? Delta y. So delta y now, moving to delta value. So this is my y coefficient, right? So instead of y coefficient, you need to substitute 6, 5 and minus 7. So instead of y coefficient, you need to substitute this value x and z as it is. Okay, but instead of 1, 3, minus 2, you have to substitute 6, 5, minus 7. See, 6, 5, minus 7. After finding, you have to find the determinant value. that is your delta y value, and delta is it na, so your z value. So z value, instead of z value, you have to take this value, and these two values remains as it is. Okay, this two values remains as it is. So I have taken the determinant. So my final answer is -99. So how will you find out x, y, and z? Yeah, this is the formula: delta x divided by delta, and for y, delta y divided by delta, and for z, delta z divided by delta. So what is your delta x? -33, and your delta value is -33. So -33 divided by 33. If I cancel balance, your answer is 1, and y value is -66 divided by -33. Your answer is 2. And this is -99 divided by -33. Your answer is 3. So your x equal to 1, y equal to 2, and z equal to 3. Okay, so this is your fourth sum. Do the rest of the sum in first Roman letter. So I'll be doing the second Roman letter in the next session. So since it is easy sums only, right? Because you need to find out delta x, delta y, and delta z. Okay. After that, you need to find out x, y, and z. So do the sums in this part, and as well here I've done 8th sum, you're supposed to do 7th sum and 7th sum and 5th sum, right? It's 5th, 7th, and your rest of the sum in first Roman letter. Okay, children, thank you.